Now, I'm not one to gossip, but I will bring you the tea. Welcome to Chronicle Speaks.
Please, please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Eh? Yes.
Look at you.
Shirley Strawberry is a well-known American radio personality.
It's your girl Shirley Strawberry. What's happening?
Best recognized for her role as co-host of the popular nationally syndicated radio show, The Steve Harvey Morning Show. Born Shirley Ann Clark, July 28, 1954, to her mother, Helen Louise Jackson Clark, and her father, Homer, Shirley was very loved and doted over at a very early age. Now, although her mother told her father spoiled her and loved to see her smile, tragedy hit the family when her father was killed in a horrific car accident, leaving Shirley with very few memories of him. Now, 5 years after Shirley's birth, her brother Anthony was born, but with Shirley being the first child and only girl, Shirley grew up being the center of attention and she absolutely loved it. Now, the family would often have dinners and a bunch of people at the home, and Shirley had to be in the middle of it all, running her mouth much like she does on the radio show now, and her mother would often tell her, "Get somewhere and sit down, little girl. Everybody has seen you." It was in those moments that Shirley knew that she had a huge purpose in life, but what that purpose was, Shirley really didn't know. Now, one person that definitely knew that Shirley was destined for success and greatness was her Uncle Wardell. He was the first person that noticed she had a very good speaking voice and that she was an excellent reader. He would show her off to his friends, bragging about his niece, putting her up against any speller because his niece was that girl. At the age of maybe 6, Shirley was given the word chaos, and she pronounced it perfectly. Her uncle was amazed. He was ecstatic. And because of moments like this, her Uncle Wardell always held a special place in Shirley's heart. As Shirley began to grow, things started to change. She wasn't always vying to be center of attention anymore. Shirley wanted to make sure that she was not an embarrassment to her mother. She never really got a chance to express herself the way she wanted to. She wasn't allowed to speak about boys, and Shirley began to feel like her mother quieting her down from these things stemmed from the tragic loss of her father, and that somehow stole a piece of her mother's self-esteem. Shirley's mother was always pretty vibrant, the life of the party, but when she became a young mother and a widow at such a young age, her mother changed in ways that Shirley never would have imagined. Now, Shirley's relationship with her mother was like most teenage girls. She really didn't understand her mother's parenting, but Shirley was not one to undermine her. She didn't get pregnant early, she didn't talk back. Needless to say, Shirley was a pretty good kid. She never really understood the reason why her mother worked so hard and spent so much time away. However, Shirley and her brother were always given nice gifts for Christmases and birthdays, gifts that would make the average rich kid's head spin. So needless to say, Shirley's expensive taste may have started early in life. Although Shirley's mother may not have been able to be around as much as she wanted to physically due to her having to work, she saw fit that her kids never wanted for anything. Now, as Shirley began to have conversations with her mother throughout the years, she began to understand her mother's upbringing, which helped Shirley to understand much more about her mother and why things were the way they were, and kind of sculpted Shirley into the mother that she wanted to be eventually. Now, as Shirley matured and made her way through grade school, she did decide to go to college, but after all, she found out that college just was not for her. Although her Uncle Wardell was a school teacher and yearned for Shirley to go and to complete college, this was not in the plans for Shirley. She had something different up her sleeve. At the tender age of 19, Shirley became involved with an extremely abusive man. At this time, Shirley's self-esteem was at an all-time low. This man would talk down to her, cheat on her, beat on her, and oftentimes take her money. Now, at the time, Shirley was a news director for a radio station and would often come to work with bruises and black eyes. After 8 years of her family not approving of this relationship and Shirley coming to work telling her co-workers horrible stories about how he treated her, she quietly snuck pieces of clothing out of the home that they shared together, and Shirley left, taking no looks back, going back to Chicago to her family with no plan, just a fresh start. Shirley then began working for WCGI in Chicago, also known as the Doug Banks Show, where she was known for her distinctive voice. Her on-air presence set her apart from the industry, giving her plenty of local popularity. However, Shirley's love life still remained damaged as she had a string of bad romances, even meeting another woman beater along the way. However, this time Shirley held her own and fought back, later promising herself that she would never let a man abuse her again. Now, it's crazy how life shapes us into these individuals that we will be later on. We've all heard Shirley go from this nice, supportive wife to her current husband, Nesto.
But you know, I always say a prayer for you. You do know that, right?
I do know that. You have some strong prayers, too. So strong.
Well, good. I'm glad they're working.
Now she is this wife that is tired of things not going right, officially grown old of putting up with betrayal, deceit, and cheating once again.
That's all. I just didn't feel like it. I didn't feel like doing any of it. I was tired. It's like, you know, I'm just too caught up in all of this jail stuff. And it's just not me. And I'm sick of it. That's it. That's all I can tell you.
With learning more about Shirley's life, her losing her father at an early age, her abusive and controlling relationships in the past, one could only see why Shirley was ready to call it quits with Mr. Nesto. But let's continue. As Shirley continued dating, she wanted to be intentional on what she asked God for. She wanted her man to be God-fearing, have a true love for God. She wanted this man to not be insecure or controlling, have good financial means that were legitimate, and she also wanted this man to be a gentleman, and he had to love women. She wanted this man to be tall, handsome, and a good dresser, someone who was well-groomed. Shirley began dating a man named Michael that she absolutely loved. They dated for years, but it was clear that Michael was not into marriage, although Shirley was. Michael worked in the record industry, with Shirley being in radio, and she felt because of that, they were a true match made in heaven. Unfortunately, Shirley moved to Los Angeles, and although these two stayed in touch, he would fly in to see her often. She did not fly in to see him, and that upset him. Shirley wanted to be married. Michael wasn't changing his mind on it, and the relationship ended. She always felt like Michael was that one that got away, but Shirley ended up meeting another Michael, Michael Strawberry, brother to the famed baseball player Daryl Strawberry. Michael Strawberry was the oldest of five kids, and he was drafted by the Los Angeles Dodgers and played baseball in his hometown for 3 years before following his childhood dream of becoming a police officer for the LAPD. Shirley, who is newly in her 40s, was ready to settle down and get married. She met Michael at church. He was a deacon, and they went on their first date. And during this date, they spoke about marriage, children, all of that hoopla. So Shirley set her sights on becoming his wife. And it didn't hurt that his last name was Strawberry. Shirley absolutely loved the sound of Shirley Strawberry. I mean, who wouldn't? Shortly after dating, Michael called Shirley and was like, "You wanna?" Shirley immediately said, yeah, not knowing what she was answering to. She was ready for her fairy tale life. She'd been with all of these abusive bozos. This one was into church. He came from a good family, and he was also a police officer. Shirley thought she had hit the jackpot. He asked her in October to marry him, and Shirley set to plan her wedding for that following New Year's Eve. Shirley began planning. She had 4 bridal showers. You know, Shirley has been over the top since childhood. She also had this big extravagant wedding, but she made sure to keep everything quiet, not letting the station that she worked for know, because they wanted her to get married on air so the listening audience could be a part of it. So although Michael was against it, Shirley had yet another wedding to help with the radio station's ratings. She also had a successful second honeymoon, and they went to Maui. After she got all of the wedding planning and events out of the way, the couple settled into their marriage. Michael quit his job as a police officer to work with his brother, but that job failed and Shirley became the major breadwinner. According to Shirley, this left her husband having major resentment towards her. They were both unhappy and they stopped communicating and being intimate 5 months into the marriage. Shirley being worried about looking like a failure, she did not want to completely walk away, so she stayed in the marriage and things only continued to get worse for the couple. Shirley realized that she failed for the wrong reasons and didn't get a chance to completely know Michael Chronicle the way she should have, but Shirley was not ready to throw in the towel just yet. The couple separated for some time, then getting back together, trying to work things out before calling quits, and that's when she discovered that she was pregnant. While being pregnant, they still were not getting along. She didn't even want to hear his voice at the time. 2 months into the pregnancy, Michael decided that he no longer wanted to be intimate with her, and Shirley just could not understand. She cooked, she cleaned, she did everything as a wife that she thought she needed to do. However, Michael just wasn't into her anymore. Shirley then gives birth to her daughter Sheridan, and things still don't change for the couple. However, they still remain together. 2 months postpartum, Michael is not wanting to be intimate with Shirley at all. Because Shirley's career was so demanding, at the age of 3 months old, Shirley sent her daughter Sheridan to live with her mother in Arizona. Michael ends up getting another job that keeps him out late at night, and he's out just a little bit too late. 2 years after Shirley had given birth, she was over it. She couldn't take it anymore. So with this continuing to be a sexless marriage, Michael not wanting to touch her since she was 2 months pregnant, now 2 years have passed, she can't take it anymore, so she decides to separate from him once again. Now, while Shirley is at work on air giving the traffic report, someone comes over to Shirley and brings her a fax. And the fax says, "Shirley, I'm a friend of Michael's girlfriend, and she had a miscarriage last night, and it was your husband's baby." Now, this was the new age way of sending text messages. We didn't know about it yet, but Shirley got that text message via fax, and it absolutely crushed her, but she had to continue her work day. Now, she went into her office, and she called Michael, and she was like, "Look, what's going on?" Michael denied, denied, denied. So she ended up getting in contact with the woman that sent the text, and she talked to her, and the woman was like, "Yeah, I'm working with the girl who was pregnant by your husband. I feel like you should know." Shirley ended up speaking to someone else who knew about the situation, and this person confirmed it as well. So Michael finally admitted, "Hey, it is true." And at that point, Shirley could not take it anymore, and she ended up filing for divorce. Shortly after Shirley Strawberry filed for divorce in the year 2000, she was introduced to Steve Harvey to be his co-host on the Steve Harvey Morning Show. The show brought her in to be the voice of reason, and Steve did not like her at all. He was not feeling the concept. You know, this is a highly male-dominated industry, and Steve wanted to be the face of his show. Fortunately for Steve, Shirley knew what she was doing. She had done this for many years, and she was able to show him the day-to-day task and how things were supposed to go, and she finally grew on him. These two became so close as friends that Shirley actually asked Steve to walk her down the aisle 15 years later to her new husband, Ernesto Williams. Long story, we'll get into that in a second. Now, the Steve Harvey Morning Show was a hit in LA from 2000 to 2005, but in the year of 2005, the Steve Harvey Morning Show was nationally syndicated, becoming one of the baddest, and I mean the baddest, radio shows in the land. Before the show became nationally syndicated, the advice column based on Shirley Strawberry's last name, Strawberry, and the Brothers Johnson's classic hit, Strawberry Letter 23, the Strawberry Letter advice column on the Steve Harvey Morning Show became a fan favorite to many. People would write in for relationship advice, and Shirley and Steve would give it to them straight, no chaser. But people often wondered, how in the world is Shirley Strawberry able to give advice on relationships when she's 1, divorced, and 2, she's still single? But with all of the trauma that Shirley has gone through in life, maybe she would be the perfect person to tell you who not to choose. And one would also think that with all of the advice that Shirley was given and the trauma that she's gone through, Shirley's next pick will be her best and her last. Well, in walks Nesto Williams. According to Essence magazine and Shirley, Shirley met her match after deciding to put more energy into her personal life and happiness. She says, "I wanted a relationship but made no room in my life for a man. I had faith that God was going to send me a man, but what was I doing? You can't go home every weekend and just sit there. You have to put yourself in the game." According to Shirley, the couple met when a mutual friend introduced them at Ernesto's concierge business. The friend made a hasty departure, leaving the duo to quickly connect. He asked her on a formal date the same day. Ernesto proposed live on the air of the Steve Harvey Morning Show with the help of Shirley's daughter. According to Shirley, she said, "I was surprised and happy."
Let me ask you this here. Would you love everything about her and everybody connected to her as if it was your own?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Shirley.
Yes.
This your man right here.
What? It's Ernesto.
Wait a minute.
He just showed Shirley a diamond ring.
Yeah.
Will you marry me?
What?
Shirley not immediately catching on to Ernesto's voice when he was live on air was a shock to many of us and a red flag to us all. Tommy was asking the questions that we were all asking in our own heads.
What the hell is going on when I'm not there?
Wait.
It's your day.
Yeah,
what the hell? Shut up.
Yeah.
Will you marry me?
What?
I will marry you.
Oh my God.
Hold on.
Huh? Who the hell is Ernesto? Who is Alfredo?
Oh my God.
Met his brother. Uh-huh. We talked extensively.
Uh-huh.
He was actually going to fly to Chicago to ask me for your hand in marriage.
What?
That's how cold he is.
Oh, look at my
he asking you for them.
Needless to say, Shirley and Ernest were married on Ernest's 50th birthday, January 9th, 2015. But unfortunately for Shirley, this was not her happily ever after. Shortly after marrying Ernest, Ernest was arrested a few times and Shirley was quite aware of it. Shirley said, "That's my man and I'ma stick beside him." She had her tall, dark man that had his own business. Shirley really didn't have to want for much, or so we thought, from the outside looking in. Shirley lived in nice, beautiful places. She drove nice cars. She had nice jewelry. Shirley was always decked in the most beautiful clothes, but that's just the outer appearance. We had no idea that Shirley had to file for bankruptcy. There were tax issues. Shirley was being evicted from multiple homes. Shirley's husband was allegedly dealing with and getting money from other women and using that money to flip in certain ways to be able to give Shirley the desires of her heart, i.e. her ring and that coveted G-Wagon that he ended up giving her for her birthday prior to him getting arrested this last time. Shirley's husband, Nesto, became headline news when the Roswell Police Department released an article stating that a man and a woman were responsible for stealing more than $1 million from at least a dozen victims. Later on, the prosecution accuses Nesto of having a girlfriend in Florida and stated that he was going to escape to Steve's house in Abu Dhabi. Shirley still decided to stick by her man for a good while, paying his attorney fees until she just could not take it anymore. In the summer of 2024, Earnest Williams was indicted on 39 Racketeer, Influence, and Corrupt Organization Act, also known as RICO. According to the charging documents, the marriage is also coming under scrutiny as the indictment claims it helped facilitate Williams' alleged criminal activity. District Attorney Fonnie Willis speaks on this case, and she believes that Shirley Strawberry met a man, fell in love and married him. However, the truth is, at the time, he was already married to someone else, a woman by the name of Martha. Ernest and Martha were married in the early 2000s. However, their marriage was not dissolved until 2021, 6 years after he married Shirley Strawberry. According to attorneys, Williams allegedly used the marriage to gain access to more victims, alleging that he defrauded at least 25 individuals out of over $750,000. Williams is alleged to have stolen personal vehicles, motorcycles, coach buses, and other property by either refusing to return said items or issuing bad checks. Ernest Williams is innocent until proven guilty. However, Shirley Strawberry obviously felt like this was too much to bear, and in April of 2024, she filed for divorce. With the relationships and the two marriages that Shirley has had in the past, I can guarantee that this is probably the most hurtful. Not only has this one been the most public, the jail phone calls have allowed us to see not only inside of their relationship, but also the relationship with the woman that he was seeing behind Shirley's back. Shirley is a strong believer in love. However, I believe that with everything that has happened in her life, this relationship may be the straw that broke the camel's back. I don't know if she's going back after this one to love, to get married, or anything. I believe Shirley's just gonna sit it out. We are going to continue to follow this story to keep you updated on everything Shirley Strawberry and Ernesto Williams. Please leave a comment and tell me what you think about this story. And you know how we do. We'll talk about it down below.
Talk to you guys later. Bye.
As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, and hit that bell so you don't miss out on any of my new episodes.